Welcome to the .NET MAUI DataForm Control tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to customize the .NET MAUI DataForm control. I will demonstrate how to restrict a data field from editing, change the label name, and hide the label for an editor. I'll also cover how to add a label icon for the editor and adjust the text style. Additionally, I will show you how to customize the editor view and explicitly create date editors. I am using an existing MAUI application where I have already configured the necessary dataForm namespace and added the MAUI dataForm control with the required data. If you want to learn how to add the dataForm control to an app, I recommend watching the Getting Started video linked in the card above. You can also download a Getting Started example from the link provided in the description below. Now I'll run the application on an Android emulator. As you can see, the dataForm automatically generates the data editor based on the property type. You can customize the data editors in two ways, using events or using attributes. In this video, I will demonstrate how to customize the editor using events. To do this, I'll start by defining the generate dataForm item event, and then navigate to its event handler method. Looking here, by default, the dataForm displays the field name as the label for an editor. I will demonstrate how to change the label text. For example, I want to display the label text with spacing. To do this, first I check if the dataForm item's field name is first name. If it is, I set its label text property to first name with a space between the words. Repeat this step for the remaining dataForm items. You can see that the label text of the dataForm items is displayed with spacing. Next, let me show you how to cancel the data editor generation for the middle name property. To do this, locate the condition for the middle name property, then set cancel to true. Notice that, in this case, the data editor is not added for the middle name property. Next, if you want to modify the data editor settings, you can do so by using the properties of dataForm item within the generate dataForm item event. However, before starting, remove the previous code changes that canceled the data editor generation for the middle name property. To restrict editing for the last name property, locate the condition for the last name property. Then, set isReadOnly property to true. Similarly, to hide the address property, navigate to the field name, address, and set is visible to false. As you can see, this action has now restricted editing for the last name property, and the address property is hidden. If you wish to display a watermark for an editor, for example, to show the watermark for the first name property, go to the field name, first name, and set an appropriate text to the placeholder text property. You can do the same for other properties. Before running the application, remove the previous code changes that modified editing restriction and visibility. As you can see, the watermark is now displayed on all the data editors. Now I will demonstrate how to customize the layout of the data editor. If you wish to adjust the label width, label position, and the editor width, you can do this using the default layout settings property of the dataForm item. To customize the layout for the address field, first, define the default layout settings property with its instance. Then, set the label position to top, label width to 100, and editor width to 200. By default, the label position is left. As you can see, the layout for the address field has now been customized. Next, let me demonstrate how to add a label icon instead of label text for an editor. For example, if I want to set the phone icon for the contact number editor, I'll navigate to the contact number condition and set a new label for the dataForm item leading view property. In this label, I'll set its text to E. Font family to input layout icons, which is already added in the resource folder. Font size to 18, and vertical text alignment to center. Before running the application, remove the previous code changes. As you can see, the phone icon is now displayed for the contact number editor. Now I will demonstrate how to customize the label and editor text styles. To customize the label text, Set a new DataForm text style element to the DataForm item's label text style property, and set its font size to 19, text color to black, and font attributes to bold. Similarly, to customize the editor text, set a new DataForm text style element to the DataForm item's editor text style property, and set its font size to 19, text color to black, and font attributes to italic. Looking here, the label text and editor text styles are customized. Next, I will demonstrate how to create data editors explicitly. Before we start, navigate to the data form on the main page XAML. To create data editors explicitly, set the auto-generate items property to false. To manually add data editors, define the items property. Within that, add a data form text item element for the text editor and set its field name and label text to first name. Similarly, do the same for the middle name and last name fields. If you want to group the phone number and email editors, add a data form group item element and set its name to contact. To include multiple fields inside the group, define the items property again. Then add a data form text item element and set its field name and label text to contact number. Similarly, add one for email. As you can see, the editors are now created explicitly for the given data. There are several types of data form item available. To learn more about these types, you can refer to the documentation link provided below. Now I will demonstrate how to customize the editor view using the data form item manager. To achieve this, create a new class named DataFormItemManagerEXT. Make this class public and inherit from DataFormItemManager. After that, override the initializeDataEditor method. Within this method, check if the editor object is an instance of the entry class. If it is, you can customize the data editor by adjusting the properties of the entry object. For example, set its font attributes property to bold and font size to 19. To assign this extension class, navigate to the data form control on the main page XAML. Define the item manager property and assign the data form item manager EXT class. As you can see, the editor view has been customized. If you want to learn about customizing the data editor by using its attributes, refer to the documentation link provided below. In this video, I have shown you how to restrict a data field from editing, change the label name, and hide the label for an editor. I also showed you how to add a label icon for the editor and adjust the text style. Additionally, I showed you how to customize the editor view and explicitly create data editors. If you want to see a working example of the features demonstrated in this video, you can download one from the GitHub link provided in this video's description. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.